Greetings, melodious viewers, and welcome to today's Cinema Scene, featuring three films that explore the lives of musicians: Latcho Drom, This Is It, and Yankee Doodle Dandy. In the remarkable film Latcho Drom, two-time César Award-winning French director Tony Guetlief gives us a fascinating glimpse into the nomadic lifestyle of the Romani people. Released in 1993, this film is the second part of a trilogy that Mr. Guetlief, who is of Romani descent himself, has created to bring attention to the rich but often misunderstood lives and culture of the Romani people. The other films in the trilogy are Les 1998 Princes and The Crazy Stranger. Filmed on location in 8 different countries, including Egypt, Turkey, Romania, Slovakia, and Spain, Latcho Drom, which means have a safe journey, transports us to another world of music, dance, and age-old traditions. The opening scene, set in the desert of Rajasthan, India, features a Romani wedding under a special tree. We immediately see how music and dance are not intended for entertainment purposes alone, but in fact play a primary role in Romani communication and life. With few subtitles and no narration, Mr. Guetlief lets the vibrant music and expression of the Romani people illustrate their dignified lifestyle. As we head to Slovakia, the beauty, peace, and joy of the Roma people are apparent. With little or no possessions, often homemade clothes, and simple musical instruments, they are able to transform any dull atmosphere into a colorful celebration of precious life. With exceptional cinematography, Latcho Drom paints an engaging picture of an artistic and peaceful culture in harmony with nature and each other. The film was honored with awards at the 1993 Cannes Film Festival, 1997 Montreal World Film Festival, and the U.S. National Society of Film Critics Awards. A series of 50 concerts in London, United Kingdom, by legendary singer, producer, dancer, and humanitarian Michael Jackson, after a decade's absence from the stage, was planned to begin in July 2009. Called This Is It, it was referred to as the greatest comeback in the history of pop music. On June 25, 2009, Michael Jackson passed away just 18 days before the first show. Footage taken during the rehearsals were made into a film, also called This Is It, which gives a glimpse of the passionate gift Michael was preparing for his fans and the audiences of the world. Released in 2009, the award-winning movie indeed showcases many of Michael's most popular songs, timeless dance moves, and the fantastic visual effects designed for the concert's theatrical musical experience. But this is far from all that the documentary has to offer. The film's director, Kenny Ortega, longtime friend of Michael, as well as director and choreographer for the concert, indicated that the footage was never intended to be revealed to the public. He said, "The recordings were made so we could use them. Then the tapes were destined for Michael's private library. They have a real unguarded honesty to them. Besides the dazzling performance and stage effects, the film shows us more of who the King of Pop really was. Extremely talented, yet humble, caring, and thoughtful." Audiences are offered an intimate look at how attentive Michael Jackson was to every detail of his performance and how closely he works with the team to perfect every scene. Michael Jackson once wrote, "It's been my dream since I was a child to somehow unite people of the world through love and music." The film shows us just how passionately Michael worked for this goal. His message of love, his concern for our planet, and his care for all the children in the world shine in the film through songs that include "Heal the World," "We Are the World," "Earth Song," and many more. Produced by Columbia Pictures in association with the Michael Jackson Company and AEG Live, This Is It is a beautiful tribute to Michael, who once stated Music has been my outlet, my gift to all the lovers in this world. Through it, my music, I know I will live forever.
We must bring salvation back. Where there is love, I'll be there. Reach out my hand to you. I have faith in all you do. Just call my name and I'll be there. Oh, oh yeah.
Our final feature is Yankee Doodle Dandy, a 1942 musical biopic about legendary American entertainer, playwright, composer, actor, singer, dancer, and producer, George M. Cohan.
Directed by Oscar winner Michael Curtiz and produced by Warner Brothers,
the film stars Oscar-winning actor James Cagney as the title character.
In the beginning of the movie, we see the elderly Mr. Cohan performing in the show I'd Rather Be Right
as the 32nd U.S. President Franklin D. Roosevelt. On the first night of the show, he is summoned to meet with the president in person at the White House. As Mr. Cohan tells the president about his life, we see on the screen how he had grown up from being a pretty quirky kid to being known as the man who owns Broadway. From an early age, George and his sister had learned singing and dancing, soon joining their parents on the vaudeville stage. The family's act, known as the Four Cohens, quickly gains popularity. By the time he's a teenager, George is already a star and even portrays his own grandfather in the theater. This role enables him to fool a young lady, Mary, who believes him to be an elder gentleman, and asks him for career advice on becoming a performer. Mary, played by Joan Leslie, eventually becomes George's wife and is the inspiration for his successful song, Mary's a Grand Old Name. George's family was always supportive and stood by his side through every up and down. Born on the 4th of July, which is the Independence Day of the U.S., George M. Cohan inherited from his parents not only artistic ability, but also a deep love for his country. During World War I, George uses his talents to support and boost patriotism through writing, producing, directing, and starring in his own musical shows. Many of his most famous patriotic songs were composed during this period, including It's a Grand Old Flag and Over There. For his uplifting contributions to the American spirit, he became the very first person to receive the Congressional Medal of Honor for artistic works. Also portrayed in the film is George's special friendship and partnership with Sam Harris, with whom he produced the first big Broadway show, Little Johnny Jones, and other popular songs. Listed in the American Film Institute's 100 Best Movies, Yankee Doodle Dandy is a genuine classic that has inspired many generations. The film won the 1943 Oscars for Best Music and Best Sound Recording, with James Cagney also winning the Academy Award for Best Actor in a leading role for his timeless portrayal of the great entertainer. Latcho Drom, This Is It, and Yankee Doodle Dandy are three marvelous films offering audiences an engaging musical experience. It was a pleasure having you with us for today's Cinema Scene. Coming up next is Vegetarianism, the Noble Way of Living, after Noteworthy News, here on Supreme Master Television. May your lives be graced with the music of the divine.
For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/CS.